This is Kate and Matt in Home Depot right now.
Yeah, we're in the Home Depot. We're looking in Lancaster. For firewood.
Firewood is nigh.
Yeah.
We'll find it very soon.
Okay.
They said it is going to be outside, so I think that will be true.
Yeah.
Oh, I almost got squished. All right, we are on the road right now. We're about 190 miles away from our campsite. We are in the beautiful part of the desert. It's going to be bordering kind of Joshua Tree type areas and the forest. And we just stopped for some In-N-Out. It was delicious. It was amazing. There's some crosses right there out in the middle of nowhere. And I think it's just going to be this, driving straight for a very long time. Kate, where are we?
We are in Inyo National Forest.
Yes, we are. This is for Jeffrey Campgrounds. We're at campsite number 13, lucky 13, baby. Let's go and just do some stuff now. So we got a rip-roaring snowmelt river just right away from our campsite. You can still see our tent right there.
I love when you talk like David Lynch.
It's me, David Lynch. I'm gonna jump over the river. It's okay. How long do you think it's gonna take to find Methuselah tomorrow?
To find Methuselah?
Yeah.
I think.
That feels like a good amount of time. Oh yeah, that's a shirt right there. That's
Can
a great shirt.
Did you see
shirt.
The lady?
Oh hell yeah, wait.
It has a sexy lady.
Perfect detail. Hello, this is a partially submerged site due to all the snow melt.
Looking Leave me the fuck alone.
Looking like a snack for bears.
But still aged 3 years, that's cool.
I like that. Aged 3 years and twist off. It's a quality
Strange.
And smart right there. That's a good fire.
Well, the seal is still mad annoying.
You still gotta stab it with a screw.
Actually, you know what? I'm gonna build hand strength. I'm gonna try.
Okay.
No, please.
Alright, okay. I gotcha. So this is the place itself. Here's the mountains. You can see the stars and the moon. You can hear kind of like the rushing of the river just because of all the snow melt. There's a nice pathway over here. So here we are driving to the ancient bristlecone pine forest in northeastern California. Well, more like mid-eastern California. We're in between two mountains on a road that, while old and kind of rickety, is very nice and is holding us together very well. Listen to some great tunes. The flowers are blooming. We got a little desert bloom going on right now. And we've not seen anyone else go this way. We've seen some people pass the other way, but it's just us going in this direction so far.
So hopefully we aren't making a horrible mistake.
Yes. In about four miles, we're going to be turning left onto White Mountain Road. And then after that, we should be able to get there in about 30 minutes.
And where are we going, Matt?
We're going to see the oldest tree in the world, the Methuselah tree, the Methuselah Grove. We don't know which tree it is, but we do know that it is there, and we know that we're going to find it. How are we going to find it, Kate? Just by vibes.
Your melon heart.
Yes.
University of California Research Stations. Thought I was done with that life.
Ah, shit. My good leader. Holy shit. I'm gonna call this a 9 out of 10 snow. Well, here we are. Pesto, pasta, and all.
Yeah.
And this is where we're going. What's your favorite of the mountains over there?
Mount Thumb. Sure.
Yeah.
It's a really good starter mountain if you're just getting into it.
We're covered in snow. You can see the mountains, a little lake right there, and that's where we're going.
Methuselah.
Methuselah.
For some reason, I have a ton of safety pins in here.
I saw that there was one broken. It was on the top of the thing.
That was because I have one time when I had checked this bag, had my sleeping bag on the outside pocket. The sleeping bag popped out and like rolled away. Okay, it's easy to tell because these
short little what do they call them? Bristles.
Bristles, yeah.
Short bristles versus these long Christmas tree looking bristles on
and
that
one.
And that's
called a limber.
This is a limber. Better identify the tree bristles.
The Methuselah Walk brochure.
This is the Methuselah Walk brochure. We didn't pay for it, so we will return it.
That's true.
It's beautiful. There's wonderful little information on it. We're going to take this 2 to 3 hour Methuselah Walk, 800 feet of elevation, bring water, snack, and sun protection, which we have. This is quite helpful and lovely. Okay, let's go over the facts of finding the ancient bristle cone again.
Exposed.
Yeah,
so ancient bristle cones live longer than the young ones because they are in areas with more dolomite-y and worse soil. And dolomite over there, so they grow slower. So there's more resin in the wood.
Less resin.
No, more resin.
Okay, more resin.
I think more. And so then they are more resistant to disease and insects.
Mm-hmm, yep.
And then they also, grow really slow.
Yeah.
And so they don't grow too big, so they can also survive longer.
Telltale signs are exposed and gnarled roots.
Yeah.
Strips of bark along the sides.
Yeah, just one strip of bark.
One big strip of bark.
And, like, besides that, having a bare trunk and branches.
Uh-huh.
Dead bristles on the top of the tree.
Uh-huh. Because don't need that anymore.
And fucking what else?
And I think there was one more, but there was like 5 main identifying. We got 4, so I think 4 should be okay.
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
Kate, thank you for being an exquisite guide through
you.
The snow.
Yeah.
I've never done that before.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Blonde boys seek the thrills.
Blonde boys have the chills. Yeah, but we're at 6 out of 24, and I think it's going to get a little easier from here on out.
12 is going to be the point where it gets easier.
12 is the point where it gets easier, because we switched to the other side of the canyon,
where
there's no snow.
Yeah!
Okay, so I think we stumbled upon some kind of weird mistake, but now we're back down.
Well, I think we walked on a trail that probably should have been closed, and probably was closed.
Probably, but... We go on because we adventure.
So now we ball down.
We ball down.
You want to show them where we came from?
We came from way up there. This is the part that I will edit out of the vlog.
I feel like we've milked this for all we can. Without...
Kind of. I think we should do one more trail.
Discovery trail.
Yeah. This sign is a dirty liar. don't believe his lies.
Post-Methuselah trail thoughts. It was
hard.
It was tough. It was a tough trail.
But it was fun.
I think we found the right one.
We definitely found the right one.
But...
we were unable to complete the full trail.
But we didn't go to the fake area that people always talk about.
Yeah, it's actually a red herring.
Yeah.
To distract. So that the public at large...
doesn't know about, like, where it is. So, yeah, the decoy trail would be really cool to go on at some point, because I've heard it's quite stunning.
Quite beautiful.
But we found the one. The picture will be right here. Ding. That was editing.
Yeah.
So now we're going to do the discovery trail, where we will discover things. And then we're going to go home. I've shoveled.
How about you discover some bitches?
Discover some fucking... Ah!
Oh, this is quite gorgeous.
There's the cooking cannery.
Zoom, zoom.
Just getting so
snow. We got to the top of the trail and we got some more snow, but it's nice snow. We got a drone near us. Oh, it's bright. But yeah, there it is.
Matt, tell us about your experience on the Methuselah Trail.
It was amazing, honestly. It was kind of everything I thought it was going to be. There was a lack of some things that I thought were going to be there, and there was more than I thought. It was just like, I feel like the transitive property of all of the things that I was expecting versus all the things I got made it like one of the best trails I've ever been on. We found Methuselah. Obviously, it was the one tree that we found, and I don't doubt that whatsoever.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna say it.
No, say it.
The real Methuselah was the friends we made along the way.
Yeah.
But like, look at those mountains. It's like I had no idea that those were even gonna be here as part of that trip, and I just can't stop looking at them in like a walker.
Yeah.
And it makes me excited to return one day. And I can't wait for that. How are you feeling, Kate? What are your thoughts?
I am excited. And look at this cool blue car. Meep, beep.
Meep, beep.
Whoa. Oh. I live in fear. I have no beer. I sleep in jail. And everything fails. 'Cause you're